This is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today, it's another Q&A day, so this is another question and answers day. I like to do these every once in a while. These are questions that go back up to 3 weeks ago. So the first question is by You Are The Deal. And the question is, what is your best pepper? And so, I don't know, I have 20 different varieties of peppers, and my best pepper, honestly, is the pepper that's truly ripe. I pick it and eat it in the garden. I mean, mostly I like sweet peppers. I don't usually like to eat hot peppers in the garden. I'll usually dehydrate my hot peppers, but I love different kinds and different varieties of sweet peppers. I like that kind of pimentos actually a lot. They're nice and thick, fresh, crunchy flesh. They're pretty good. I like those a lot. They're a sweeter pepper. I don't like bell peppers too much, especially when I'm growing them, because they're kind of like, they take a long time to ripen up. So I prefer the little small peppers. So maybe like miniature bells. They have miniature red, yellow, and orange bells. I'd recommend those. Or the balloon peppers are really fun pepper. Look those up. They're really funky shapes and sizes. I had some videos last year of them. They look like UFOs. V Karma asks, do you use only non-GMO organic seeds? The answer is no. I definitely use non-GMO seeds. That's absolutely a requirement. I will not plant any GMO seeds, but I don't always use organic seeds. And the reason why is this. While I try to do all organic, some seed varieties that I want to grow are literally not certified organic. Definitely getting certified organic seeds and wild and heirloom seeds, definitely I encourage, and everybody should do that. But sometimes, you know, it would really limit me if I only grew things that were raised in an organic state. A lot of seeds may be organically produced, but they're just not certified, so they can't be labeled organic. I do try to, you know, grow many different varieties of things, and I wish everything was all organic, but it's just not. I do stay away from, you know, general conventional seed companies. You know, a lot of seed companies will put coatings and different chemicals on the seeds and treat the seeds for different reasons. And I generally stay away from those. I can't remember buying any actually treated commercial seeds. So definitely grow naturally, absolutely. And I did do a show on seed companies where I show a couple different catalogs of seed companies. That was in the early spring when I was recommending people buy their seeds to get them in early so they'll have their seeds for summertime. One of the ones that come to mind that I really like is called bountifulgardens.org. It's a great organization that sells seeds. They have many different varieties, but check my other videos for that. The other thing I recommend that I didn't talk about back then was actually Seed Savers of America. So I'll have an upcoming episode about Seed Savers of America. I'm a member. That's probably one of the best places to get seeds from, because it's actually just home gardeners like you and me that are saving some of their seeds and sharing them with other people. And some of those seeds are really rare and hard to find. ZocDog asks, hi John, awesome work and video. Can you use bricks to build a square foot garden? Absolutely. I just uploaded the video on visiting a local community garden where they didn't have any sides to contain their raised beds, and they just literally piled up soil to make the raised beds. You could use wood, bricks, you know, stones, I mean, plastic, lumber. I don't know, maybe you could probably use, you know, Coke bottles, like inverted upside down, filled up with soil, and I mean, glass. Anything you could do to line a bed so the soil won't come out is fair game. Definitely some materials will last longer than others. I think bricks are an excellent way to do it. Concrete, you could pour your own forms, do concrete, many different options. And each material has their pros and cons. So, you know, wood's really easy to work with, relatively inexpensive. Cons would be it's going to break down pretty, you know, sooner than concrete, which will last forever, or bricks will last forever. So definitely pros and cons to every different raised bed material. SB Howard 22 asks, wow, John, how do you make time to make so many interesting videos and tend to the garden too? Do you get an excess of veggies? So I'm a really huge multitasker. I don't know. I do, like, my brain works so fast, and you know, I have help here in my garden, and that's another thing. I couldn't do without the help of Sage and Tiffany, although we lost Sage, and I'll have an upcoming video on that too. Yeah, definitely help with my gardeners, and you know, I also make the time. I mean, for me, gardening is very important to me. It's important to grow my own food, to eat the highest quality food, so I'll be the healthiest. And I hope everybody out there would, you know, take it seriously too, because I mean, we're not taught how to grow our foods in our schooling system. I mean, food's essential for life for us, and we should all be taught how to grow our food, and we're not. So I'm relearning, you know, our original roots and learning how to grow food, identify food by, you know, looking at it growing in the wild and all these things like that. And I think everybody should do it too. And yes, I do have an excess of veggies. I have friends that I'll, you know, I give my veggies to. Hopefully start a CSA program here one of these days when I get some more help here. And like last night, I cut my tree collards, which I'm sitting next to, down and, you know, sold bunches of tree collard leaves for a dollar at my local potluck, and to, you know, let people know how good tree collards could taste. And everybody who tasted them, wow, these are really sweet. And that's what they said. TFurkUS01 asked, how much time do you spend each day working in your garden? I might spend an hour, if that, every day. Some days zero, some days four. TFurkUS01 also asked, do you massage your kale with anything before you put them in your salad? I never ever massage my kale with anything. A lot of people massage kale with either salt or oil. I don't believe in using those things too often at all. And you know, my kale, just fresh picked kale, is so tender and so good. I think people massage with oil and salt because most kale you buy in the store is really bitter and nasty tasting. So you need to make it taste better. And you know, if you add fat or add salt to anything, it's gonna taste better. But when you have really good fresh kale, you know, it doesn't need to be, you don't need to add anything. Two Brain asks, how much did you pay for your cedar fencing? I emailed a few places and they quoted about $280 each per plank. That sounds kind of expensive. That's a 4-inch by 6 foot links. I paid 45 cents after coupon for my cedar fencing. I did get that on clearance. Normally they're about $2, and I got the, you know, the smaller width. That's a 4-inch width. 6-inch width usually runs about $2 here in California, but I guess it depends on the area where you live. You could also use redwood fencing. I did recently buy some redwood fencing for the project for my friend at her apartment, and they're about also $2 a board for a fence post or fence, you know, boards, right? ASFX2600 asks, can you recommend a way to get enough soil to fill up 4x9x24 beds in Las Vegas without buying like 150 expensive bags of soil? I'm not too familiar with Las Vegas. I have been there and know that there are some places in Las Vegas. I'd definitely check with the local nursery. So, you know, you could fill your beds by buying bags at like your local Home Depot or big box store, or, you know, hopefully if there's a composting, you know, like we have Sonoma Compost here where they take yard waste and make compost, you could check with local nurseries in your area and see if they sell bulk organic soil or compost for you. I know in Las Vegas there's a place out of the outskirts, a company that just deals with soils, and you might want to check with the master gardeners. I think I found out from them where to get the soil. It was one of the master gardeners I asked where she gets her soil, and you know, they could recommend you know, places to in your area. You could buy by the truckload and even get it delivered. It's probably much less expensive than buying it by the bag. And definitely add your rock dust, don't forget. Zippo Power asks, Mr. Juice Man, please tell us where we can purchase one of the juicers you use on YouTube. Is there a website we can go to? Absolutely. You know, and here's my standard disclaimer: for a living, I sell juicers, so I'd encourage everybody to visit my website, discountjuicers.com. Once again, that's discountjuicers.com, to buy your next juicer. On my website, you'll see many different juicers, and I also have YouTube videos. Go figure, on many of the different juicers. I have over 100 YouTube videos on juicers and other equipment that allow you to eat more fresh fruits and vegetables in your diet, so you can see how each specific juicer works. Because, you know, many people say, hey John, what's the best juicer? And I'm like, I don't know, what do you want to use it for? You know, there isn't necessarily a best juicer, but there's a best juicer that'll meet your specific needs, and depending on what you want to juice with it, you know, and if you want fast cleanup or easy cleanup or higher nutrient quality, or, you know, large feed chute, you know, least amount of noise so it's quiet. So many different factors to take into consideration when buying a juicer. So definitely check out my website and check out my YouTube videos on juicing to learn more about juicing. Last question of the day is, Nubster12 asks, are you vegetarian? If so, can you recommend any good resources for recipes or meal planning? I primarily eat a vegetarian-based natural diet. Absolutely, and I'd recommend two websites, GoVeg, G-O-V-E-G dot O-R-G, GoVeg.org, and PCRM.org. Those are two very good websites to learn about eating more, basically, fresh fruits and vegetables and getting them in your diet. I do advocate that just everybody eats more, you know, plant foods and fresh fruits and vegetables in their diet in their most natural, raw, and unprocessed state. I mean, if you think about it, if you look into nature, I try to look into nature for many answers here in my garden and in life in general. If you look into nature, most every animal on earth eats, you know, whether they're an herbivore or carnivore, they eat their food naturally. They'll kill it, they'll pick it instantly, they'll eat it, you know, and whether they're a carnivore eating meat or, herbivore eating plants, you know, they eat their food fresh. And that's one of the main keys of gardening is we want to pick our food and eat it fresh. We don't, you know, in nature, there's no such thing as a refrigerator. You know, animals don't go and pick their leaves and store them up, you know, in their fridge. They literally eat them off the bush, off the plant. And that's what we want to be doing too, to get the maximum, you know, nutrient quality and highest nutrition out of all these things we're growing in plants. So this is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time.